सपोज दिस इज वन कॉनकेव हेक्साहेक्साना, जनरली वेयर वी टेक द ऑब्जेक्ट नाना?
ऑन द वे
ऑन द प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस, बट आई एम टेकिंग द ऑब्जेक्ट समवेयर हियर, नॉट टेकिंग ऑन द प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस, समवेयर हियर, एंड आई एम गिविंग इट्स कोऑर्डिनेट्स. ओके, लाइक द एक्स कोऑर्डिनेट इज 10 सेंटीमीटर्स एंड हियर वाई कोऑर्डिनेट इज सम 4 सेंटीमीटर्स, बोथ आर इन सेंटीमीटर्स. 10 comma 4 in centimeters. Okay, and its focal length is equals to, take it as some 8 centimeters. Then what will be the coordinates of image? Okay, if they ask, first of all, how to solve this one?
Sir, principal on principal axis center the x-axis, sir. X-axis 10 meters above on the length 10, sir. Height.
Height 10 or
height 4?
Sir, height 4,
right.
So height of object you are taking it as 4. Very good. And here the distance from the mirror will you say? Why? Because x coordinate is given here.
10, sir.
So you can take the distance of object x coordinate. You take it as u. U equals to 10 centimeters. So coordinates of image means x coordinate is v equals to how much? Okay. And y coordinate. Y coordinate means what, Nana? Of image. X coordinate is V and Y coordinate is height of image. So what are the coordinates of image he is asking? I think you can calculate. First by 1 by
equal to 1 by U equal to 1 by Fs.
I think you can solve. Use the sign conventions now.
Minus minus.
Okay. So here we found E is equals to, using the sign conventions, minus 40, that is HI by HO minus V. So this is 40 by 10 equals to HI by HO 4.
Minus 16, sir.
Minus 16 centimeters. So I think its coordinates of image means, so V is equals to 40. 40 somewhere here, 40. And height of image minus 16 means below. So somewhere here the image will be 40. This is the position of image. And its coordinates will be 40, x coordinate. And y coordinate will be 16. So correct, Anna? In centimeters. Both are in centimeters. Suppose, because it is one concave mirror again, certain focal length. Focal length is equal to, say, some 10 centimeters. Okay. And here, one object is placed on the principal axis, okay, at a distance of u is equals to 20 centimeters. Okay.
Focal length, sir. 10, sir.
Focal length 10. Focal length 10.
Okay, sir.
Here object distance u equals to, that is 20 centimeters. Okay. Here suppose this concave mirror exactly at the pole split into two parts, means cut now, cut that length, sorry, mirror into two parts. Okay, and here the two parts are moved apart, means this is the principal axis, After cutting, the upper part is shifted to here. Okay, this is the upper part of the mirror. And the lower part of the mirror also shifted down equally like this up to here. Okay. Means after cutting, the two parts are separated equally. How much is that? Here the upper part is shifted by say some 2 centimeters. Lower part is also shifted by 2 centimeters. Okay. Suppose you take it as some 3 centimeters. So that we can do both separately. Okay. 2 centimeters and 3 centimeters. And here this is the original principal axis and that the object is placed as usual at 20 centimeters. Okay, here before starting the problem, Anna, once we think after cutting, will the focal length of mirror change?
No, sir.
Okay. Right. So here in case of cutting, the focal length does not change. Focal length means curvature is not changed. So the radius of curvature remains same. That implies focal length remains same. So first we understood one concept here. In case of cutting, the focal length does not change for a mirror. Okay. And number two, after shifting, my question is, for the upper part, I think exactly cut a corner. So it is the pole for the first upper part. From the pole, if you take one line perpendicular to the tangent, that should be the principal axis.
Yes, sir.
My intention is, I think what you took previously, the original principal axis, is not the principal axis for the mirror after shifting. Correct?
Sir.
That's why here my doubt is, if it is the principal axis for the upper part, look at, the object is not exactly on the principal axis.
Yes, sir, then it will change, sir.
Means for the new principal axis, the object is appeared to be located below or above the principal axis now. To the new principal axis. Below means I have to assume one object like this. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
So here, where the image is formed on the other side, of course I can calculate using the formula what 1 by V plus 1 by U equals to 1 by F. V will be how much now after using the sign convention minus and minus here? I don't think it has 10, Anna. Why? Because it is appeared to be 2 times 2 focal length. This U is equals to 2F. If U is equals to 2F, image distance will also be 2F. In theory, we discussed. Or else, if you substitute the values also, you will get the same, Anna. V value. Okay, since U is equal, or else in a short way also we can say, since U is equals to 2F, 2 times of focal length, B is also at 2F. So B is equals to, you are using the sign conventions, you are telling B is equals to minus 20 centimeters. All right, okay. Means image will be formed on the same side. Exactly where here. Okay, at 20 centimeters. Now my question is, to the new principal axis, the object is not on the principal axis. That's why, if you see there, the object appeared as having some height below the principal axis. How much is this height, if you see there? How much is this?
2, sir. 2 centimeters.
So I'm taking height of object is equals to below the new principal axis, dotted one. So minus, sign convention, minus here, height of object is 2 centimeters. Okay. Then to find out the height of image, again, height of image already we did here, how to calculate using the magnification formula. minus v by u equals to h I by h u whole. Okay, so that implies minus v by u is 1. Both are same. U is equals to minus 20, v is also minus 20. Okay, so v by u is minus 1 is equals to height of image by height of object is minus 20. Sorry, minus 2 centimeters. That implies height of image is equals to plus 2 centimeters, I thought. Am I right, Nana? So the image is formed here. Okay. Plus 2 centimeters means above the new principal axis. Okay. The image is formed here at a distance of, if you see, from the original principal axis. Okay. This is 2 centimeters, Nana. Height of image also you form 2 centimeters. So from the original principal axis, what will be the distance, Nana? This distance? So here it will be formed. First image I1 is formed at a distance of from the original principal axis 20 centimeters on x axis and 4 centimeters on y axis. So understood that one, Nana?
Yes, sir.
In the same way, if you come to the second part of the mirror, okay, here for the second part of the mirror, look at Nana. I think it is the new principal axis.
Yes,
sir. Am I right? Object is here means appeared to be above the new principal axis.
Yes, sir.
Above the new principal axis and height of object this time I take it as how much, Nana?
3
centimeters above the principal axis, new principal axis. So plus 3 centimeters. Okay. Above this new principal axis of the second part. Okay, and the object obviously already calculated here v and u, Nana. V is equals to minus 20, u is minus 20 means magnification minus v by u is nothing but minus 1. Okay, so height of hi by ho is 3. Hi, how much you are getting, Nana? Minus 3 means below the principal axis, new principal axis. So below the new principal axis, here it is the second image formed. Okay. From the original principal axis, will you say the coordinates, Nana? X coordinate I will say, tell, that is 20. Y coordinate?
Minus 3.
Y coordinate?
6, sir.
From the original principal axis, 6 centimeters. Okay. So now you understood, Nana? What are the coordinates of first image and second image if they ask? Be right here. 20, 4 and here 20, 6. Okay. With the sign conventions also we can say I1 coordinates with the sign conventions is equals to here on the same side of the mirror, minus 20. And above the principal axis, plus 4. And I2 will be on the same side of the mirror, minus 20, below the principal axis. So minus 3, sorry, minus 6. If they ask using the sign conventions, okay, without the sign conventions, already we drew, we represented them in the diagram. Okay, and here if they ask in the same question, what will be the distance of the two points where the two images are formed? Okay, is 10. Very good. So distance between I1 and I2 even though they ask in exam like this, distance between I1 and I2, that we say it is equals to 10 centimeters. Very good. It is 4 and it is 6, all together 10. So here suppose, again, if I take one concave mirror here, this is the concave mirror. Take the focal length as some 20 centimeters. Okay. And here, this is as usual, the principal axis. On the principal axis, I am taking one object, point object. And it is trying to move parallel to the principal axis, means along the principal axis, towards the mirror, with a velocity of object equals to say some 10 meters per second. Okay, Nana?
Yes, sir.
When it is at a distance of from the pole, 30 centimeters from the mirror, at that instant, what will be the velocity of image? Velocity of image equals to how much? Okay, this is one question. Along the principal axis means, in the previous problems already I told, along the principal axis we use this formula, 1 by v plus 1 by u equals to 1 by f. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
And perpendicular to the principal axis we use the magnification formula. Okay. And here in this formula, Nana, before applying the sign conventions, we check the object distance continuously change due to the moment of object. So that image distance also will be changed continuously. U and V are variables, Nana. But I think focal length is constant. Focal length of the mirror does not change. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
And that too, these are distances. Object distance and image distance. So if I differentiate, then already we know dx by dt is equals to velocity. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
So if I differentiate u, I will get velocity of object, and by differentiating v, I will get velocity of image. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
So I am going to differentiate this equation. So differentiate minus 1 by v square
into dv by dt.
Dv by dt. That one only I am taking it as velocity of image. Okay.
Into minus 1 by u square into du by dt.
Very good. So minus 1 by u square into du by dt. That one I am taking it as velocity of object here. Okay. Equals to differentiation of that one equals to 0. So here you are almost getting the answer. Velocity of image equals to, if I take to the other hand,
du by dt minus of.
Minus of v square by u square into velocity of object. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
But v by u is the magnification.
Yes, sir.
It is appeared like, or you can write m square into v. You can remember it as a formula. Okay?
Okay.
So every time we are not going to differentiate. Okay? Simple. Theory is, when the object moves along the principal axis, then its velocity is, velocity of image is minus m square into v naught. Next time, straight away we come to this form.
Okay, sir.
Where m, magnification, here focal length and object distance are given. But magnification formula is minus v by q.
Yes, sir. U is equal.
Instead of finding out v naught, why don't you write the formula straight away? How, sir? Multiply the whole equation with v naught.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
1 plus v one by plus, u.
V by u is equals to?
V by f.
V by f. Okay.
V by u equal to v by f minus 1.
We know v or u.
U we know, sir.
That's why better we multiply both sides with u. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
That time also u by u is 1 plus this will become u by v. Am I right?
Yes, sir. 30 by 20.
Wait. First I am going to derive the formula. U by f minus 1. This will be u minus f by f. Am I right?
Yes, sir. V by u equal to 2 by 3.
F by u minus f. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Right. This is the story. So v by u is equals to, finally I got f by, how much you are getting on magnification there?
2 by 3, yeah, sir.
2 by 3, yeah? Wait, I will check. Magnification is equals to actually minus v by u. Minus v by u means m is equals to f by f minus v. Okay, minus taken inside. So it is our shortcut formula. Next time while solving the numericals, we use that formula straight away.
Minus 0.8 or such.
So here I think you said is what you said is correct. The last year magnification we got 2 by 5. I think it is correct. Correct only. So minus 4 by 25 into velocity of object given as 10. 5 twos are 5 fives. Minus 8 by 5. How much you told, Nana?
8 by 5.
When the object approaches the mirror, then image tries to go away from the mirror, man. So opposite direction, you got the answer 1.6 meters per second. Velocity of image. Okay. Better I write these two shortcuts somewhere here. Velocity of image, we got the shortcut minus m square into vo. Okay. When the object is moving parallel to the principal axis. And number two, magnification in terms of focal length and object distance is f by f minus u. Okay, but keep in mind, again we have to substitute the sign convention of that one. Okay, now? Right.
Good.
This is the story, Nana. Next one. So here the mistake, what we did, minus 20. Here also minus 20.
Minus
20 by, here how much we get, Nana?
10.
Plus 10, I think.
Minus 2, sir.
Magnification is minus. So I think magnification is not 2 by 5. Magnification is minus 2. So magnification minus 2 means it will become 4. Am I right? Then it is not 8 by 5. This will be 4. Yeah. Now we are right. 40 meters per second, this is. Suppose if I give, the object is trying to move perpendicular to the principal axis line. And velocity object, you take it as same, 10 meters per second. Then again, I'm asking, at this position, what will be the velocity? When the object is at this position, what will be the velocity of image?
Sir, image height and the chapter, sir.
That we will calculate. First of all, by theory, what I'm saying, m is equals to minus v by u. Okay? That is equals to height of image by height of object.
2, minus 2, sir.
What?
Magnification, sir.
Magnification, of course. Magnification, by using the formula, you are telling that f by f minus u. That is minus 2. Right, correct. But my question is, I accept that. Is equals to m. But my question is, here is the m constant or variable?
Constant error, sir.
Why? How can you say that it is consistent?
So we are taking it at 30 centimeters now, sir.
Means distance of object is not changing. Why? Because even though while it is moving upwards, okay, distance of object will change, na? When it comes to here, there, 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 while moving along this line, what is the distance of object from the principal axis? 30 or different? 30 or something, or will be changed?
30, yes, sir.
Means u is constant. Okay, u is constant. Obviously, v is constant. According to the formula, 1 by v plus 1 by u equals to 1 by f. Why? Because f is already a constant. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
So u is not changing, f is not changing. Therefore, v is constant. If these two are constant, then magnification will be constant or variable. Why I am asking like that? Here, to find out the height, velocity of image perpendicular to the principal axis, I have to differentiate this equation. Okay? Height of image is equal to m into height of object. While differentiating, is the m constant or variable? If so d by dt of h I equals to m constant, if I come to know easily, I can take it out from differentiation. M into d h o by dt. Am I right, Nana?
Yes, sir.
Suppose m is not constant, then?
Then UV formula, sir.
Good. Next model, that one we will take. Okay, if m is not constant, then what to do?
Okay. Minus 20, sir.
Minus 20, magnification is minus 2. And here dHO by dt is velocity of object. Okay. That is equals to minus 20. Correct one. Minus 20 meters per second. Minus means will it go down or up?
Down, sir.
So when the object is moving up, image will go down with a velocity. Velocity of image is equals to, I got 20 meters per second downwards.
Yes, sir.
Okay. V. What V, Nana?
Image distance, sir.
Image distance. They won't give you, Nana. Generally, they give object distance. If object is not taken on principal axis, height of the object and velocity of here the object towards the principal axis, towards the concave mirror, 20 centimeters per second given.
Ekkada anukovali sir, ippudu manam 20 centimeters unnappudu anukovali kada sir.
Yes. Equals to, at the instant when the object is at a distance of 20 centimeters, f by f minus u, f is equals to minus 30, by f is minus 30, minus u is minus 20. I am getting minus 30 by minus 10. So I am also getting plus 3. Correct only now. M is equals to plus 3. Principal axis, parallel to the principal axis, will you find the velocity of image? Parallel to the principal axis.
Minus 180.
Can I take it as V, velocity of image along x-axis now?
Yes, sir.
Is equals to along x-axis how much? I think you are using this formula.
Yes, sir.
Therefore, VI along x-axis, you are telling that minus 9. M square is 9. 9 into VO, 20. How much you told, Anna?
180.
Minus 180 centimeters per second. Okay, correct, Anna. I accept it. This is the velocity of image. Now, perpendicular to the principal axis, will it change? That is the question now. Here, if you see, problem is in this model, Nana, magnification generally we write minus V by U. Of course, we calculated that one. It is plus 3.
Yes, sir.
Okay. At that instant, and that magnification we write it as hi by ho. Okay, is equals to m. Here my question is, height of object I think constant.
Yes, sir.
So here hi is equals to, if I write it as m into ho, while differentiating in the previous problem, magnification constant.
Yes, sir.
But in this problem, look at ho is constant. Understood my logic, Nana?
So into dm by dt.
Dm by dt means really the magnification is changing or not. If you see, magnification changes, Nana. Why? Because if u is changed, v also will be changed. So that magnification also will be changed.
Yes, sir.
Then how to find the dm by dt value here?
M equal to minus v by u, sir.
Yeah. Then what to do? Differentiate means dm by dt equals to
U by V formula చేసుకోవచ్చు లేకపోతే మైనస్ యూ ఇంటూ వన్ బై వి చేసుకొని యూవి కూడా చేసుకోవచ్చు సార్
దట్ ఈస్ యువర్ బెస్ట్ వి బై యూ ఆల్రెడీ యూ నో నా యూ బై వి ఫార్ములా
yes sir
so u into dv by dt am I right
yes sir
minus u means v into du by dt by u by v square according to the formula, but here u square. Am I right, Nana?
Yes, sir.
Now substitute the values here. Minus of u into dv by dt is velocity of image, Nana. Dv by dt is velocity of image or velocity of object?
Image, sir.
Along x axis already you calculated, Nana.
Minus
v into du by dt. Du by dt is velocity of object or something?
Object, yes, sir.
Along x-axis by u square. Okay. I think previously, luckily, you calculated the v value.
Sir, 60.
How much you calculated, Nana? 60, yeah? Minus 60 or plus 60?
Plus 60, yes, sir.
All right. Now you can substitute all the values. U, already you know 20. 20 means minus 20, sign convention. Okay. Along x-axis, velocity of object is, we are taking towards, that is suppose plus 20 centimeters per second. Okay. Then velocity of image, we got here. How much, Nana? Minus 180. Along x-axis. So
12, sir.
Huh?
Equal to 12.
Plus 12.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Plus 12. Dm by dt after substituting all the values.
Minus 6.
Dm by dt is equals to minus 6. Okay. That you substitute here, Nana. Then you will get velocity of object along y-axis. Sorry, velocity of image. Image along y-axis equals to, I am getting from this formula, ho, height of object, how much is that? 2 centimeters.
Minus
2 into dm by dt minus 6. So this is equals to minus 12 centimeters per second. Am I right, Nana?
Yes, sir.
So will we write that all together? Okay, this is along x-axis. So finally, velocity of image is equals to minus 180 I cap. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
And minus 12 J cap in centimeters per second.
Yes, sir.
All right. So these are the cos theta sin theta concept. If the object suppose moves like this, making an angle theta, your problem is the object is moving towards the concave mirror with a certain velocity, means velocity of image along the x-axis, that will be always easy, Nana. directly you can use the formula minus m square into velocity of object along x-axis.
Sure.
Okay, where m is equal to, you can use that formula. Okay, f by f minus. This will be easy. The problem is here, the velocity of image along y-axis, that is problematic on all the times.
Okay.
Here problem is, velocity of image generally how we calculate? By taking, first magnification is equals to minus v by u, we calculate the magnification. And that magnification equals to h I by h o.
Yes,
am I right,
ma'am? Yes, sir.
Therefore, height of image is equals to magnification into height of object. Okay. Once you look at this formula, ma'am, first of all, is the magnification constant?
No, sir.
Means it is a variable. Okay. Now, it is trying to move along y-axis also. So, height of object continuously change or constant?
Yes.
Means both are changing or not?
Yes, sir.
So, here while differentiating, what to do? We have to use the UV method. So in that case, velocity of image along y-axis, UV method, first m into dho by dt plus ho into dm by dt. Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
That implies m into dho by dt, velocity of object along y-axis, plus ho into here what dm by dt. That dm by dt previously we calculated now in the problem, where dm by dt is equals to u into minus u into dv by dt
minus
v into du by dt by v square. We already used this formula. Where dv by dt is velocity of image along x-axis, du by dt is velocity of object along x-axis. Look at here how much complexity is there when it has some velocity along x-axis as well as along y-axis simultaneously.
Okay, sir.
By taking focal length is equals to 20, object distance is equals to at that instant 30 centimeters. Okay, na? And the velocity of object is given as some 2 meters per second. Means this is 2 meters per second. Okay. And okay, the object is initially at a height of object initially equals to 2 centimeters. And the angle theta equals to 53 degrees. Okay. Do you know cos 53 and sin 53 now?
3 by 5, 4 by 5 also.
Right. So, no problem. Okay. Using that data, you have to find out here what will be VI initially and VI along x-axis, VI along y-axis.
Yes, sir.
The concave mirror, except for U is less than F, it forms inverted image or erect image? Except u is less than f. Except in this case, means for all cases u greater than or equals to f. It forms inverted or erect?
Erect, sir.
Concave, ma'am.
Sir, inverted, sir.
Concave always forms inverted image for erect object. Okay,
yes,
provided u is less than f, then it forms the erect image.
Yes.
For the erect object.
Yes, sir.
Okay. That is one concept related to concave mirror. There I am asking, is this practically useful to use the concept of inverted image? Okay. If you see it, what he says, dentists generally use to see the teeth, that means actually gums, okay, gums of teeth, to see the gums of teeth, generally they use which type of mirror?
Concave.
So we say here, objective point here, dentists use concave mirror to see the gums of teeth. Okay, why? Because gums are at the bottom now. Okay, ivi gums generally teeth ela untundi. Okay, when they want to see, this image should be formed like this, inverted, then gum will come to the top so that they can see the gums, whether they are damaged or not, directly they can see.
Yes sir.
Okay, and number 2, convex mirror, nana
bikes mirror, rear view mirror.
Why they use the convex mirror as the rear view mirror in the bikes and cars? Because they always form virtual image. Okay, virtual image is always erect image. Okay, right.